Just a quick note before I start the playthrough, because Blackmore originally recorded two tracks, left and right, but I wasn't able to create a backing track that mutes both, therefore I'm kind of merging the two. But I did tab both of the original guitar tracks, and you can find that tab and download it on patreon.com/dr2boss. So let's get into it now. Panned to the hard left, and kind of a lead, or you know, licks are panned to the hard right, and we'll discuss shortly about both. And I always say, let's just shortly discuss something, and I ramble on. Once again, I'm going to try not to do that. So let's quickly start with what Blackmore does not play, and it is the organ riff. So he's not playing the organ riff that John Lord plays, but he's really smartly reinforcing these same chords and the rhythm in the same time, and doing so by playing something else. So you don't always have to play the same riff, the bass, the organ, and the guitar. And this is a good lesson in that, I think. So what Jamal plays is basically dyads, much like what Ben Moore often does, Smoke on the Water, Menace, Element, and most of his iconic riffs. So it's not really a chord, but a fragment of a chord. So this we can call D, this is an A major, this is C, and then back to D. Join it against an A bass note. So what Ben Moore does is actually plays somewhat Smoke on the Water over it. Now the great thing about this is that, like I said, he's reinforcing the main chords, but also the beat with these chugs or rhythmic whatever's they are. I'm not sure what they are called. I'm gonna call them chugs. If it's not a chug, then please let me know in the comment and I can learn something too. And this is true for the whole rhythm track. When you go into the chorus, this will help you lock in with the bass and the drums. And it is really important because this is one of the most overrated skills. So people always think about guitar legends as how great their solo technique is and their solos are, how fast they are, how tasteful their bends are. And it is very important. But all of them, especially Blackmore, was also a great rhythm player. He can play in the pocket. He can play really tight. Now, I'm not so great in that, or with that, but for I Just Take Your Life, it has a really good groove that I mostly can catch. So I think it could be a good way to getting into rhythm for some of you who haven't paid enough attention to rhythm yet. So try to end this, because it helps your hand keep the groove by doing something and not just, fading, but also sort of being like a metronome, going constantly. And then let's also talk about the licks, or sort of the ornamentations, or maybe the lead channel, because Blackmore doesn't play much. He actually mostly just plays the major pentatonic, but it adds a really nice layer, and you can really get a lot of mileage out of the major pentatonic. Blackmore often used that in conjunction with the minor pentatonic. Maybe that's a topic for a different lesson, but for now let's just learn the major pentatonic in D. If you don't know, it's basically the lick he plays. So sometimes he does end this C note, which is not on the major pentatonic, it's on the minor pentatonic, because it's the minor 7, the B7, but it kind of works, because if you take a major scale and add the minor 7, or basically lower the major 7 to a minor 7, you get a Mixolydian scale. So that works. The first thing that I want to mention is, if you want to learn about Blackmore's pentatonic or major pentatonic soloing, you can check out the solo of Since You've Been Gone, the alto solo of Since You've Been Gone, key of A, and he's exclusively playing the major pentatonic, which is pretty rare. But let me give you a couple of ideas how to use this. So, easy enough. So, you can come up here. And this is basically D major from your B. You can also bend into it. You can add this half step here. And then you kind of get a bluegrass run. Minor pentatonic. So Blackmore plays this in D, then when they modulate to B, also in A over the D chord and the A chord, and when they modulate to B, because originally the song is in the key of A, and he starts on the fourth, and they come up with the... And then he does the same thing over the E as well. And then again, he plays a couple of variations when they go up to E. This is how it gets to be. So I guess my point is, learning this can take you to maybe, well, Southern rock if you play it in a rock context, but the major pentatonic scale is kind of the country pentatonic scale. And country players do use the minor pentatonic as well, but sort of, you know, the major pentatonic has that country sound. So let me give you an example in D, and I think you can get a really, you know, lot of mileage out of it. If you're playing it in the key of E, or just simply stay, now this is something you cannot do with a strat, because the tremolo detunes the band. You know, if you're doing a unison, it detunes it. Doesn't matter if you're bending in tune, you would need to adjust, but I never learned that, because I mostly do this on teddies, which are hardtail. So, well, I don't necessarily want to teach you all these licks, but just wanted to open up the possibilities and show you that the major pentatonic is really, really useful in many contexts, and you can see Blackmore uses it a lot. So next time, if you're jamming over a song, you know, maybe try it. If it can work over a dominant 7 chord, the beauty of that in the blues, most of the chords are, you know, dominant 7, so... And you can therefore... You can use both your major and minor pentatonics, because in a dominant 7 you have the major 4, but you also have the minor 7. This is basically the Mixolydian that I talked about. So by the book, probably the Mixolydian scale, so the major scale with a lowered 7th is the best for it, but you can play your minor, then you can play your major pentatonic. Now maybe, again, that's another lesson. And I do have another channel, youtube.com/bluesless music, where I do more country stuff and I have countryish lessons. So if you're interested, check that out. I think, again, I rambled on like usually, but I hope there were nuggets of information for you regarding Majestic Your Life. And if there wasn't, sorry, but at least you got the tab and seen the playthrough. And like I said before, you can download the whole tab of both tracks on patreon.com/dogwithtwobones. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.